time, Pete.
I'm glad you know.
I always do with you.
I'm glad.
And the stars are just... I didn't know you know all that stuff.
Well, it's not. Time. It's just stuff like that.
Pete?
Yeah?
I love you.
I love you too.
Oh.
Oh, are you cold? Do you want to go inside?
No. I just want to sit like this, close. I feel so close to you tonight. It's nice to be close to you, Pete. It's safe. I like being close, like this. I mean, I can think of other ways of being close to you. But that's not. I like this right now. This kind of close, right next to you. You know, right now, I think I'm about as close to you as I can possibly be.
Well, not really.
What?
Not really. I mean, if you think about it in a different way, you're not really close to me at all. You're actually as far away from me as you can possibly be. I mean, if you think about it technically, if assuming the world is round, like a ball. Like a snowball, the farthest away from somebody is if you're right next to them. See, if I'm here and you're here, then that's far.
Yeah.
But now you're closer.
Yeah.
And closer. And closer and closer. And closer and closer and closer. Closer and closer.
Someone. I was just about to go to bed. I saw you from my window. Is there something I can do for you?
No. I'm just here to see the Northern Lights.
Okay. It's awful late, and you're in my yard.
Oh, I hope you don't mind. I'll only be here tonight. I'll see them tonight, the Northern Lights, and then I'll be gone. I hope you don't mind.
Is that your tent?
Yes.
You've pitched
a
tent in my
yard. So I've got a place to sleep after I see them. I hope you don't mind.
Well, I don't know if I mind.
But do you mind?
Well, it's not that I mind. I just think...
Oh, no. I think you mind.
Oh, no. It's not that I mind.
No, you do. Oh, my gosh. I am so sorry. I didn't think you would mind. I didn't think... See, it says in your brochure that... People from Maine wouldn't mind. It says that people from Maine are different, that they live life the way life should be. And that in the tradition of their brethren in rural northern climes, like Scandinavia, that they'll let people who are complete strangers, like cross-country skiers and bikers and hikers, camp out in their yards if they need to for nothing. They'll just let them. I'm a hiker. Is that true?
Well...
That they'll just let you camp out in their yards if you need to? Because I need to camp out. Because I'm where I need to be. This is the farthest I've ever traveled. I'm from a part of the country that's a little bit closer to things. Never been this far north before. Or east. And did you know that Maine is the only state in the country that's connected to only one other state? It is! It feels like the end of the world out here. And Here I am at the end of the world, so I was counting on staying here, unless it's not true. I mean, is it true?
Well,
would you let a hiker who is where she needed to be camp out in your yard for free?
Well,
I mean, if a person really needs to.
Well,
like really, really needed
well,
to.
Well, if a person really needed to,
oh,
sure,
I'm
but.
Oh, I'm so glad then. Thank you.
Sure, sure.
Oh my gosh, I need that.
Oh, here.
Thank you.
Here. You're welcome. Okay, so you're just looking for a place to see the Northern Lights from then?
Yeah, it's just tonight.
Well, you know, you might not see him tonight, because...
Oh, no, I'll see them, because I'm in a good place. Your latitude is good, and this is the right time. Solar activity is at an 11-year peak. Everything's in order. And boy, do you have good sky for it. There's lots of sky here.
Used to be a potato farm.
I was gonna say... No trees in the way. And it's flat. It makes for a big sky. So, you're a farmer?
No, used to be a farm. I'm a repairman.
Oh.
Fix things.
Oh.
What?
If you're not a lobster man.
No.
I guess I just thought that everyone from Maine was a lobster man and... talked in that funny way they do in Maine, and you don't talk like that.
Nope, you're not down east, you're up north, and this is how we talk up north, pretty much.
Oh.
Plus, ocean's a couple hundred miles away, be an awful long ride to work if I was a lobster man.
Yeah. Well, anyways, thank you. Thank you for letting me stay here. I've had a bad enough time of things, not to be given a bad time.
Oh boy. I'm sorry. I think I love you.
Really?
Yeah, I saw you from my window and I love you.
Well, that's very nice. But there's something I think you should know. I'm not here for that.
Oh, no, I didn't think you were.
I'm here to pay my respects to my husband.
Oh.
Yeah. My husband, Wes. I just wanted to say goodbye to him because he died recently. On Tuesday, actually. And, see, the Northern Lights. Did you know this? The Northern Lights are really the torches that the recently departed carry with them so that they can find their way to heaven. And see, it takes 3 days for a soul to make its way to heaven, and this is Friday. This is the third day, so you see, I will see them. The Northern Lights, because they're him. He'll be carrying one of the torches. And see, I didn't leave things well with him, so I was just hoping that I could come here and say goodbye and not be bothered. But what you did there just a second ago, that bothered me, I think. And I'm not here for that. So maybe I should just go and find another yard.
No, I'm sorry if I've behaved in a way that I shouldn't have.
No, I
really... No, really, I don't know what happened.
Well, I do. I know what happened.
I'm not the kind of person who just would do something like that. Please, don't go. Just do what you need to do. I won't bother you. Maybe just consider what I did a very warm Maine welcome.
All right. My name's Glory.
I'm East. Name of a town a little ways that way. Mess up on the birth certificate. A son, Easton, born on this 6th day of January. 1987 in the town of Matthew, Maine, instead of the other way around.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Nah.
So, Easton.
Yeah.
Yeah, I passed through near there on my way here. And, by the way, where is here? Where am I? I couldn't find it on my map.
Almost.
What?
Township 13, Range 7. It's not going to be on your map, because we're not a town, technically.
What do you mean?
Well, see, to be a town, you gotta get organized, and, well, we never really got around to getting organized, so we're just almost.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh!
What?
Oh.
What's wrong?
My heart!
What?
My
Are
heart!
You okay?
My heart! You have my heart!
I?
In that bag! It's in that bag!
Oh,
please,
oh,
give it back
okay,
to me! Please,
okay,
it's my heart!
Okay.
I need it! Thank you.
You're welcome. I'm sorry. Did you just say that your heart is in that bag? Is that what you just said? That your heart is...
Yeah.
It's heavy.
Yeah.
Why is it in that bag?
Because it's how I carry it around.
Why?
Because it's broken.
Well, what happened?
Wes broke it.
Your husband?
Yeah. He went away.
Oh.
With someone else.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah. And when he did that, I just felt like my heart would break. And that's exactly what happened. It broke. Hardened up and cracked right in two. It hurt so bad I had to go to the hospital. And when I got there, they told me they were gonna have to take it out. And when they took it out, they dropped it on the floor and it broke into 19 pieces. Slate. It turned right to slate.
Great for roofing. Wait a second. How do you breathe if your heart is in that bag? How are you alive?
Artificial.
Really?
Yeah, because my real one's broken.
Well, then why is it in that bag?
Because I carry it around that way. It's my heart.
But it's broken.
Yeah.
Because your husband left you.
Yeah.
Well, then why are you paying your respects to him if he left you?
That's what you do when a person dies. You pay them respects.
But he left you.
Yeah.
And it seems to me that a man who leaves somebody doesn't deserve any respects.
Well, I just didn't leave things well with him, and
what
I need to
mean?
Apologize to him.
But he left you.
I know, but I
just... Why should you apologize?
Because...
Because why?
Because I killed him.
Oh.
I'd like to apologize to him. See? He had come to visit me when I was in the hospital. I was almost better. I was just about to go home, too. And he said that he wanted me back. And I told him, Wes, I have a new heart now. And I'm sorry, but it doesn't want you back. And that just killed him.
Oh, but it didn't kill him. You didn't kill him.
Yes, I did. Because he got so sad that my new heart didn't want him back, that he just tore out of that hospital. And an ambulance that was coming in from an emergency didn't see him and just took him right out. And if I had been able to take him back,
Glory.
He wouldn't have torn out there like that.
Glory.
He would have been just taken out like that. And so I just feel that for closure, the right thing to do is just... Please don't do that anymore.
Why? I love you.
Well, don't.
Why?
Because I can't love you back. I have a heart that can pump my blood, and that's all. The other one is broken. It doesn't work anymore.
Please let me have
no,
this.
No, it's mine.
I can fix it.
I don't know if I want you to.
Glory?
Eat, please, give that back to me.
It's no good like that.
But it's my heart, please.
Yes, it is. And I believe I have it. And I can fix it. I'm a repairman. I repair things. It's what I do.
Oh. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. They're so beautiful. Oh. Oh. goodbye, Wes. I'm so sorry. Goodbye, Wes. Hello, East.
Sandrine!
Hmm?
Hey!
Jimmy!
Hey!
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 Hey! How are you doing?
I'm doing good. How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing good. Good. Great. How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
Great.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah.
You look great.
Oh.
You look great.
Thanks.
You do. You look so great.
Thanks, Jimmy.
You're so pretty. So pretty.
Thanks.
Here, have a seat.
Oh, Jimmy, I can't.
Oh, come on. I haven't seen you in, well, months.
Yeah?
And months and months and months and months and months. How's that happen? Live in the same town as someone and never see you.
I don't know.
I haven't seen you since that night before the morning when I woke up and you were just gone.
Yeah. I look at you two tucked away in the corner over here. Lucky I found you. Is the man and his lovely lady ready for another round?
Well,
no, we're not together.
Really?
We're all fine, thanks.
Yeah.
All set.
Yeah.
Okay, well, call if you need anything.
Thanks.
No, really, you gotta holler. It's busy up front.
So,
okay.
You hear anybody, or?
Yeah, the girls.
Oh.
It's some, girls of mine. We're in the front, actually. I just had to use the ladies' room, so I should probably get back to them.
Oh, come on. They'll survive without you for a minute or two. So what's been... Here. What's been going on? What you been up to?
Well,
did you know that I took over Dad's business?
Heard
I'm
that.
Running it now. I'm
heard
running
that.
It. Running the business. Running the show.
Good
running
for
the
you.
Whole shebang.
Good for you.
Thanks. Yeah. We still do heating and cooling. And we've expanded now. We do rugs now. We shampoo them.
Oh.
It's a lot of work. A lot of work, I'm on call a lot. Weekends, holidays, you name it. Because your heat goes out, people die. It's serious.
Yeah.
Yeah, like I let the guys who work for me, like East, he helps repair sometimes. I let them have the day off so that they can be with their families since I'm all alone this year.
Aww.
Yeah, I do Thanksgiving, Christmas. I really don't have anybody anymore, really. Brother and sister got cancer, left town, and
right.
Mom and Dad retired, headed south.
Heard that.
Yeah, Vermont. Winter's there a lot easier. And I don't know if you've heard, but Spotwind died on me.
Oh, Jimmy, I didn't know that.
Yeah, he was old. It was his time. He was a good fish, though. But, like I said, I really don't have anybody anymore. Really. So, I was wondering, would you like to come over? It'd be fun. Catch up, hang out.
Oh,
And I forgot to tell you, don't forget, Friday night special at the Moose Patty. Drink free if you're sad. So if you're sad, or you two little lovebirds are ready for another couple of buds or something, you let me know, all right?
We're...
Okay.
Okay.
So, what do you say? Wanna come over for fun?
Oh, Jimmy, I can't. I can't. I really gotta get back with the girls.
Nah.
Yeah, Jimmy. Yeah, because actually, you see, oh gosh, I've been meaning to tell you this for a while now. There's a guy, Jimmy. I've got a guy.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, good for you. Getting yourself out there. Moving on.
Well, actually, Jimmy, it's more than me just getting myself out there and moving on. This is my, bachelorette party. I'm getting married.
Oh.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, that's... I thought you said you weren't gonna do that. Get married. Thought it wasn't for you, you told me. Guess it just wasn't for you with me. So, who's the lucky guy?
Martin LaFerriere, you know him, the,
the ranger guy, over in Ashland.
Yeah,
he's a legend. Legendary. I mean, if you're lost in the mountain, Maine, he's the guy you want looking for it.
Yeah.
I mean, if you're lost out there in the big, bad, the northern world, Martin LaFerriere's the guy you want to have go out there and find you.
Yeah.
And he found you.
Yeah. I'm sorry I never told you. I thought you would have known. I thought you would have heard.
How would I have heard?
Well, you know, people talk.
Not about things they know you don't want to hear they don't. And I gotta be honest, that's not something I would have wanted to hear. So when's the big event?
Tomorrow.
Really?
Yep.
Well then. Calling for a waitress. She said to holler. What's her name?
I don't know. She's new here.
Hey!
What are you doing?
You got found and you deserve it. He's quite a guy.
Jimmy.
And so are you.
Jimmy.
Hey!
Jimmy? Jimmy? Well, hey. What's that?
Oh, nothing. Tattoo. Hey!
What?
Tattoo. Hey!
Jimmy, when did you get that?
After you left. Nothing, nothing. Hey, hey, hey! No.
Villain.
Villain.
Who's villain?
Villain. It's supposed to say villain.
What?
It's supposed to say villain.
Well, it doesn't say villain. It says villain.
I know. I spelled it wrong.
What?
They spelled it wrong. It says villain, but it's supposed to say villain.
Well, why do you have a tattoo that says villain? Why would anyone want a tattoo that says villain?
Cause
why?
Just cause.
Just cause why?
Just cause when a guy's got a girl like you, well, just to think that losing a girl like you, driving a girl like you away, it's just plain
Jimmy,
criminal.
Jimmy, you didn't
it's
drive
criminal.
Me away.
It's villainy. So I marked myself a villain, so
Jimmy,
that girls would stay away.
It was my
so I never
choice.
Have to go through what I went through with you again. Can I kiss you?
No. You can get that undone, you know.
Yeah.
Well, I got ahead.
Yeah. Hey, I'm glad you got found.
Thanks, Jimmy. Hey, sorry. You were waving me down. I saw you, but so busy in the front. There's this bachelorette party. Those girls. Good thing it's not drink free if you're glad. Because those girls are wicked glad. Gosh, I had to find my way through just to find you. But I did it. I found you. So, what'd you need? What can I do you for? Another bud? Oh, pal. Well, like I said, you're free if you're sad, okay? Just tell me you're sad and you'll drink free. Just say the word. Let me know, because I know if I'm sad and you're looking pretty sad. Okay, well, my name's Villian, if you need anything.
Villian?
Yeah?
Hi.
Hi.
I'm not sad. I just like another bud.
Alright.
Villian.
Yeah?
I'm glad you found me.
Aw. I'm glad you found me. That's adorable.
Yeah.
No, you're not. I just smashed into the ironing board. I wasn't even looking. Are you hurt?
No.
Oh, you must be. I just smashed you. Where did I get you?
In the head.
Okay.
Well, is there any blood?
No.
Any discoloration?
No.
And I'm okay.
Girl, I'm gonna go get you some ice.
No, I can't feel things like that.
Like what?
Like when I get smashed in the head with an ironing board. I don't get hurt.
What?
I can't feel pain.
Oh, jeez, I'm pro. What the hell have I done to you?
Nothing.
You're talking, Loopy. Listen to you going on about not being in pain. That's delusional. I've knocked this center out of you.
No, I'm okay.
Shh. Listen, I was gonna be a nurse, so I know you're hurt. You just took a good shot to the head, and that's serious.
No, it's not serious. I don't think any ironing board could really hurt your head. Because, see, ironing boards aren't on a list of things that can hurt you. And plus, there's no blood or discoloration
from
where I got hit. And my list is pretty reliable because my brother Paul is helping me make it. And I can prove it to you too. I bet if I took this ironing board, like this, and hit you with it, it wouldn't hurt. See?
Ow!
Oh no! It did.
Why did you do that?
I didn't think it would, because see, ironing boards aren't on my list of things that could hurt you, but gosh, maybe they should be.
What are you talking about?
I have a list of things that can hurt you, and ironing boards aren't on it.
Well, that ironing board hurt me.
Yeah.
So you should add it to your list.
Yeah. Should I be afraid of ironing boards?
Well, if someone swings at your head and wallops you with it, yes.
Well, it's not. I have a list of things to be afraid of, too. And ironing boards aren't on this list, either.
Well, they shouldn't be, really.
No?
No, you shouldn't be afraid of ironing boards.
No?
No.
But they can hurt me.
Yeah.
So I should be afraid of them.
No.
So I shouldn't be afraid of
right.
them? Right. But they can hurt you?
Well, if you're used the way you used it, yeah.
Oh, so they're kind of like the opposite of God.
What?
Well, ironing boards can hurt me, but I shouldn't be afraid of them. And God, my brother Paul says, God won't hurt me, but I should be afraid of him.
I guess.
Boy, this is getting very confusing.
What?
This business of learning what hurts, what doesn't
hurt,
what to be
afraid
of, what
not to be afraid
of. Are you sure
you're okay? You're just going on about crazy stuff.
Oh, yeah. I have congenital analgesia, he thinks.
What?
Most people, congenital analgesia.
Who thinks?
My brother Paul. Most people call it hereditary sensory neuropathy type 4, but it just means I can't feel pain. You can hit me if you want to see.
No.
Go ahead. It won't hurt. See?
Ow!
See?
Ow!
See?
Ow!
Go ahead.
No.
Come on.
No.
Come on.
No.
Okay, you don't have to. Most people don't hit me. Most people just go away. You can go away too if you want to. That's what most people do when I tell them about myself. My brother Paul says I just shouldn't tell people about myself because I scare them. So I've actually recently put myself on my list of things to be afraid of, but...
Oh my gosh, I'm sorry!
Me.
Oh my gosh, just
talk to
you!
You hit me.
I had to see, but are you okay?
Yeah, I can't
Don't feel pain, right? Of course you're okay, but are you sure?
Well, is there any blood?
No.
Any discoloration?
No.
Then I'm okay.
Well, buddy, you can be hurt and not even look like it.
But...
Trust me. There are things that hurt you that make you bruised and bloody, and there are things that hurt you that don't make you bruised and bloody, and they all hurt. I'm Marvelyn.
I'm Steve. I live on the third floor, room 11.
I live with my boyfriend Eric. I love him very much.
Yeah, we saw you move in.
Yeah, our roof collapsed from all the snow in December. We're just here until we can get our feet back on the ground.
Oh, well that's good, because that's what Maude Dudley says her boarding house is. A place where people can live until they get their feet back on the ground. My brother Paul says we've been trying to get our feet back on the ground our whole lives.
Oh.
Yeah, it takes some people longer to do that than others.
Yeah.
You guys are loud.
Huh?
You and Eric, you yell and bang, we're right below you.
Oh. Sorry about that. We're going through a rough patch. It happens. Sorry. What is it like?
What?
To not feel pain.
I don't know. I don't really know what it's like to hurt, so I don't know. I don't really feel.
Is this how you were born?
Yeah, I don't have fully developed pain sensors. They're immature, my brother Paul says. And because they're immature...
How does he know that?
Oh, he reads. And because they're immature, my development as a human being has been retarded, he says. But he teaches me what hurts, though.
Why?
So that I won't ruin myself. I have to memorize what might hurt because my mind can't tell me when to be afraid because my body doesn't know what being hurt is. So I memorize what might hurt.
Okay.
And I memorize what to be afraid of. Things like guns and knives, and fire, and fear. I should fear itself. and pretty girls.
Pretty girls?
Yeah.
Why should we be pretty girls?
Because my brother Paul says that they can make you love them, and that's something I'm supposed to be afraid of too, is love. But Paul says I'm really lucky, because I'll probably never have to deal with love. As a result of dealing with amnesia, I have a lot of deficiencies and not very many capacities.
Wait, what do you mean you're never going to have to deal with love? Why?
Because I'm never going to know what it feels like, he says.
How does he know that?
Because it hurts.
It shouldn't.
Plus, I have a lot of deficiencies and not very many capacities.
You know what? A lot of people. I'm sorry. I'm so really sorry. Are you okay? Are you alright?
Well, is there any blood?
No.
Then I'm alright.
Yeah, you are. I'm so sorry I did that. It's just, you're just very sweet.
But you have a boyfriend, and you love him very much.
Yes, I do, and yes, I do.
And you just kissed me.
Yes, I did.
And it's Friday night, and you're doing your laundry.
Yes, I am.
And people who are in love with each other, they don't kiss other people and do their laundry on Friday nights. I've learned that. People who are in love with each other, they go to the Moose Patty, or they go dancing together, or they go skating. They don't kiss other people and do their laundry on Friday nights. You know, I don't think that's love.
I've been down here longer than I said I'd be, and he's like that.
Who?
My boyfriend.
Who you love very much?
Yes.
Even though you kissed me?
Yes.
Wow, I'm gonna have to talk to my brother Paul about this.
No, don't talk to your brother Paul about this. Tell him to stop teaching you.
What?
Whatever it is he's teaching you, tell him to stop. What he's teaching you isn't something you wanna know.
But I have to learn from him.
Look, I was gonna be a nurse, so I know. You need to go to a doctor and not have your brother read whatever it is he reads.
But
you know what? I gotta go.
Right. You're leaving.
No, yes. I just have to. I told you, Eric doesn't like it if...
Who?
My boyfriend. He doesn't like it if I've been down here looking and said I'd be, and I've been down here...
Ow.
Oh my gosh, I'm sorry. I'm so
Ow.
Sorry. Are you alright? I can't believe I just did that to you again.
Ow.
Wait. What did you say?
Ow. Hold on.
Yeah.
What the heck?
I'm not sure that I have room.
Well, you guys will have to find another place for it, won't you? Now, I think it's only fair for you to give me mine back because I want it back.
All the love I gave to you?
Yeah?
I want it back. So, go get it. Lendl, go get it. Please. Now.
Okay.
What is that?
It's all the love you gave me.
That is not. There's no way. That is not. Is that all I gave you?
It's all I could find.
Oh. Okay. Okay.
Gail, what's going on here?
I told you we're done.
Why do you keep saying that?
Because when I asked you if you ever thought we were going to get married. Remember when I asked you that? In December, it was snowing.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, when I asked you that, you got so quiet. And everybody said that that right there should have told me everything.
Everybody who?
Everybody.
Who?
Marvelyn said...
Marvelyn said that. Like,
yes, she's and how quiet you got was all I needed to know, and she's right. You don't love me.
What? No, Gail, no.
And I've been trying to fix that. I've tried to make you love me by giving you every bit of love I had, and now I don't have any love for me left, and that's not good for a person. And so that's why I want all the love I gave you back, because I want to bring it with me.
Where are you going?
I need to get away from things.
What things? There aren't any things in this town to get away from.
Yes, there are. You!
Me!
Yes, you and things in this town I need to get away from, because I have to think and start over, and so all the love I gave to you, I want it back in case I need it, because I can't very well go around giving your love, because that's all I have right now is the love you gave me. I can't very well go around giving your love to other guys.
Other
that just
guys?
Doesn't seem
there
right.
There are other guys?
No, not yet, but I'm assuming there will be.
Daryl!
So I think since I know now that you're not ready to do what comes next, for people who have been together for quite a long time, I think we're going to be done.
Gail, why?
So I think the best thing we can do is just return the love we gave to each other and call it even. Oh, jeez, I'm crow. Was this really all the love I gave you, Lendl? I mean, I thought. I mean, what kind of person am I if this is all the love I gave you? No. No. I know I gave you more than that, Lendl. I know it. Did you lose it?
What? No.
Did you lose it, Lendl?
No.
Because I think you're pulling something on me, and this is not a good time to be pulling something on me.
I'm not pulling something on you. I wouldn't do that to you. It's just. I think maybe you should just take what you came for. And I guess I'll see you later.
Lendl! Lendl? What is this? What the heck is this, Lendl? This is not the love I gave you, Lendl. At least have the decency to give me back what... Lendl, what is this?
It's a ring, Gail.
What?
It's a ring.
What? What the... This isn't... This is not... Oh, Lendl, this is a ring! This is a ring! A ring that you give to someone you've been with for quite a long time. If you want to let them know you're ready for what comes next, for people who've been together for quite a long time.
Yep.
Oh, but all the love I gave to you, where is it?
That's it right there, Gail.
But...
It is, that's it. That's it, right there. I had so much. You gave me so much over the years.
11 years.
Yeah. You gave me so much. I didn't know what to do with it all. I had to put some in the garage, some in the shed. I asked my dad if he had any suggestions on what to do with it. He said, "You got a ring yet?" I said, "No." He said, "Get her one. It's time. When you got that much of that stuff coming in, it's about the only place you can put it." He said it all fit. He was right. This thing is a lot bigger than it looks. So, here it is. All the love you gave to me. Just not in the same form as when you gave it.
Yeah.
You still want it back?
Yes, I do.
Well then.
Can I keep all that?
It's yours.
Thank you. Lendl, you didn't have to get me a ring. That's not what
yes,
I was asking.
Yes, I did. It was time. And it's honorable.
Well, it's very beautiful. Lendl, I'm so sorry. It's just, it's a Friday night. I was sitting home by myself. I didn't even...
And sad. But you didn't win.
What do you mean?
beat being told you smell bad.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Well then.
Mine's face broke.
What?
His face broke.
His
face broke, yeah.
How did his face break?
When we were dancing.
Dancing? Darren Romance took you dancing.
Yeah.
Down to the rec center?
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice. It's fun.
Yeah.
What a good guy. Mm-hmm. Wouldn't have expected that from him. Wish someone would take me dancing.
Yeah.
Must have been so fun.
Well, yeah, kinda till his face broke.
What happened?
Well, we did that thing where they have you pay, you get a lesson, and you dance all night, they teach together dancing. How to dance together?
Oh, it's nice. It's fun.
Yeah, and well, we learned that thing when you throw the girl up and over, and well, Darren was having a hard time figuring out really how to do it, and it's so easy. So I thought maybe it'd help him if once through we switched. And well, I mean, Darren's not a very big guy. I mean, he's little.
He is, isn't he?
Yeah. Never really realized it before. He's a lot taller on the phone.
He does.
Yeah. And so, anyway, we switched so it could help him get down his part. And, well, I mean, I'm pretty strong and he's just small.
He really is, isn't he?
Yeah. And so, when I went to throw him up and over, I threw him over. And he landed on his face. And it broke.
Ooh!
Popular, orbital,
ooh!
Had to take him to the emergency.
That's a drive.
38 miles.
Yeah.
And he cried.
Oh!
The whole way. Asking to call his mom to come and get him.
Seriously?
And she did. Asking me to please leave.
Oh, Dean. I'm so sorry.
It's all right. She was a lousy dancer anyway.
Most of them are.
What?
That's just pretty bad.
Yeah.
And sad.
Yeah. So, I'm guessing I win.
Oh, yeah. No question. That right there might make you the big winner of all time.
Thank you.
Baddest day girl of all time.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
So, what do you pick tomorrow?
Bowling. Supper at the Snowmobile Club. Couple beers at the Moose Patty. Hang out.
Sounds good.
What?
Well, Dean, I don't know. Just sometimes, I don't know why I bother going out. I mean, I know why it's because you gotta go out. But I'm scared because I've been going out and nothing's coming of it, you know? And I feel like I'm running out of chances, and lately I've been wondering why I even have to bother going out. I mean, I don't like it, Dina. I hate it. I hate going out on all these dates. Why do I want to spend my Friday night hanging out with some guy I might maybe like when I can be spending it hanging out with someone I know I like you, you know?
Yeah.
And, I mean, that was rough in the middle of Todd telling me he didn't like the way I smelled. I mean, he doesn't smell all that great.
Not most of them do.
Yeah. Well, anyway, I got so sad.
But it wasn't you, it wasn't you.
I know. But after he said that, all I could think about was
how not much in this world makes me feel good or makes much sense anymore. Cuts so scared, you know, because there's gotta be something at this stage of the game. There's gotta be something that makes you feel good or at least makes sense, or what's the point, right?
Yeah.
And, well, I kind of came out of feeling sad and actually felt okay because I realized that there is something at this stage of the game, and there is one thing in this world that makes me feel really good, and that does make sense. And it's you. It's always been you.
Huh?
Nothing.
Hey, Shell, I should get going home. The cats get lonely.
Yeah, well, I only have to go into the mill early tomorrow. Just got some maintenance issues to resolve, and I bet I'll be done before noon so I can pick you up at lunch break.
I don't think...
Oh, they got the crossfire going on at church. Maybe we can hit that before bowling.
Oh, I don't know. Shell, you know what? I kind of forgot. I've got a big day tomorrow. We're doing Sandrine St. Perrier's wedding. We're doing the bride's hair, the bridesmaid's hair, the mom's hair, all the makeup and nails, and I don't know if I'll be up for anything afterwards.
Well, I'll pick you up whenever you're done like we planned.
Yeah, no, I'm probably going to be exhausted.
Well, we could skip bowling and just do supper at the snowmobile club.
No, Shell, how about this? How about we give it a few days and wait to see when we both have time, okay?
Well, I'll be ready whenever you want me to come pick you up.
Yeah, Shell, I'm going to head, okay?
Christopher's only this weekend.
I'm gonna go. Okay?
Okay.
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 Bye.
Bye. Hey, Dina!
Whoa. Shell, you okay?
Yeah.
Here.
Thanks.
What just happened there?
I just fell.
I know. Saw.
No, I think I just fell in love with you there, Dina.
Shelly.
Oh boy.
Yep. That's what that was. Me falling in love with you.
Well, would you cut that out?
I can't help it, Dina. It just kind of came over me. Falling in love with you.
Shelly, I'm your best friend in the whole world. And I don't know if I know what you're doing or what you're going on about, but what do you mean? What are you saying? We're friends, Shell. Best friends. And, I mean, yeah, it's true. You're about the only thing that makes sense and that feels really good in this world, too. And you've always kept me from making me feel like I'm gonna become that crazy cat lady. But now, what you've done and what you've said, now it feels like for sure I'm gonna become that crazy cat lady. And it doesn't feel good, Shell. And we're friends. We're best friends. And there's a line when you're best friends that you don't cross. And you cross it.
Thank you. still feels like you're mad.
I'm not mad.
But
I
you were.
I just said I wish
you
could pay more
mad.
Attention lately. I'm not mad. I was having fun. I thought I had fun tonight. Did you?
Yeah.
Good.
I mean, I was late because Shelley called me into the mill. I had to work. I need the hours.
I'm not mad at you, Phil. You had to work.
I did.
I get it. Phil, where's my shoe?
Huh?
Where's my shoe? I can't find it.
Well, it's gotta be here.
Is it? Is this you being funny?
No.
Because it's not funny. It's Coda.
Well, you're the one that wanted to go skating.
Phil!
We'll find it. It's gotta be here.
I'm not mad. I was never mad. I was disappointed. But now, I'm done.
Mars.
I had fun tonight. Skating. I thought it would be fun.
It was.
Look at all the stuff. Get us away from the kids. Get us back to where we used to be. We went skating. First time you kissed me on a Friday night. Just like this one. Remember? Right here. Echo Pond.
I know where we are. Where the heck is your shoe? Maybe it's in the car. Did you put your skates on out here or in the car?
I put them on with you. Right here.
Well, it's not in the car.
Oh,
what?
Sir.
What?
Jeez,
where?
Sir.
Where?
Shh, I'm wishing. Wait. I'm wishing.
I missed it.
Yeah, you did.
Well, what's that supposed to mean?
Nothing. It's just not really all that surprising.
What?
That you didn't see it.
What?
The shooting star.
Why?
You don't pay attention, Phil.
See, when you say things like that, it feels like you're still mad.
I'm not.
Mars.
I'm not mad. Where is my shoe? Gosh, maybe it is in the car.
It's not in the car.
I mean, I have one shown already. I know I didn't put my skates in the car, because the shoe I have on was out there. I changed out there, didn't I? With you, Phil? Phil, I put my shoes right next to yours after we put our skates on. But it's not there. This is the weirdest thing. It's not in the car. I mean, I'm not going to put one skate on in the car, the other on out here. What's wrong?
What? Oh, nothing. I'm just making a wish of my own on a regular one.
Oh.
You want to wish on it with me?
Yeah, that'd be nice. Which one?
See Hedgehog Mountain?
Uh-huh.
Straight up, right above it.
The bright.
Yeah.
That one.
Yeah.
Right there.
Yeah.
Phil.
Yeah?
That's a planet.
What?
That's a planet, wishing on a planet.
That's a...
Yeah.
Well, how do you know?
And it's when you push upon a star, not when you push upon a planet.
I know, Saturn. I know. How do you know?
Set on the weather, Phil. Saturn's the brightest object in the sky this month. It'll be sitting right above Hedgehog Mountain over the next bunch of weeks. They've been saying it on the weather all week. And your wish is never going to come true if you're wishing on a planet.
Well,
you gotta pay attention.
Why do you keep saying that?
What?
That I gotta pay attention.
Because you don't.
What are you talking about?
Phil, happy anniversary.
Oh.
Huh?
Happy anniversary. That's what I'm talking about.
I knew you were mad. You're mad at me. Pretty soon, out of nowhere, it's gonna get ugly.
Phil, I'm not
I mean,
mad.
Mars, I'm sorry. I know I missed some things, but I gotta take a double when Shelley needs me at the mill. She's helping me, us,
I
out,
know.
You know?
I
offering
know.
Me the overtime. No, you don't know. Me working is for us and the kids, and it's a lot sometimes, and it messes me up.
Phil, I'm not mad about you working. You gotta work. I understand that. What I don't understand is why I'm lonely. I got a husband and a couple of great kids, and I'm lonely. You don't pay attention anymore. You go away, and I don't know where you go, but you go somewhere where you can't pay attention. And you miss Missy's birthday, and you forget your son's first varsity hockey game.
hockey equipment costs
and
money.
You forget your anniversary. I mean, I brought you here, hoping you would remember about us, but you didn't. And that makes me so mad. I don't know what to do anymore.
You lie.
What?
You lie so bad. You're
what?
Mad at me, but you don't tell me, even when I ask you over and
because
over
you wouldn't
and over.
Pay attention.
No,
I did
no,
tell you.
No, because you don't know how to tell me how you feel about me, so I never know where I am, where I stand. And you know what? Maybe that's why I go away, so I can know where I am for a second. And you sent me there. You went away a long time before I did, and now all you do is lie.
I don't lie.
Yes, you do. You say you're not mad, but you're mad. You say you had fun, but you didn't. You didn't have fun tonight, did you?
No!
But you kept saying you did.
I didn't. I didn't have fun. I don't have fun with you anymore, Phil. Did you?
No. I had a rotten, lousy time.
Well then, what are we doing? What are we waiting for?
Just a minute.
I know this isn't going to be very easy, but I was just out there all alone in the world, and I got so scared because all I could think about was how I had no place in this world. But then I just, out of nowhere, realized that there was one place that I did have, and that was with you. So I flew and I took a taxi to get to you. I just had to come see you. Think I'd hear... Oh. Wait. Way up there, because, you know,
think most small towns don't really know each other any better than in big towns. You know that? I mean, you know who you know, and you don't know who you don't know, just like anywhere else. I'm so sorry to have bothered you. I was just so sure. When his parents passed away, he kept the house, I heard. He lived here, he stayed here. I thought he was one of the ones who stayed. I didn't stay, I went away.
Most people do.
Yeah, I guess he did too. I never thought he would. Guess I lost track. Gotta hold on, people, or you lose them. Wish there was something you could keep them in for when you need them. Oh, there he is, perfect. Oh, it's cold. I forgot.
Yeah.
I can't believe I took a taxi here from Bangor to see him.
That's far.
Yeah.
That's 163 miles.
Yeah. This place is a little farther away from things than I remember.
Why did you do that?
Because I could only fly as close as Bangor, and I needed to get to him as fast as I could.
Why?
Because I want to answer a question he asked me.
Oh.
The last time I saw him, he asked me a very important question, and I didn't answer it. And that's not a very nice thing to do to a person.
Well, that's being a little hard on yourself, don't you?
He asked me to marry him.
Oh. And you?
Didn't answer. No. Yeah, and that's why I'm here, to answer him. I didn't answer him in the first place because I didn't have an answer at the time. I mean, I was going to college, and the night before I'm about to go off into the world and do what I hope and dream, he asked me, will you marry me? I mean, come on. I was leaving in the morning. What was I supposed to do?
I don't know.
I mean, I told him I'd have to think about it, and that I'd think it overnight, and that I'd be back before the sun came up with an answer. And I left him standing right there, and then didn't make it back before the sun came up, or at all.
Well, that sounds like an answer to me.
No, that wasn't my answer. I went off into the world, and that's not an answer, I think.
What?
I think he thought I'd say yes.
Well, a guy's not gonna ask a girl that question unless he thinks she's gonna say yes.
I know, and I'm afraid he probably waited up all night hoping for me to come by. And I just want to tell him that I now know you can't do a thing like not answer a question like the one he asked me. You can't do that to a person, especially to someone you love.
You love him?
Well, I don't know if... I mean, we were kids. Yes, I did. I do. I feel like I dashed his hopes and dreams.
Oh, come on. You give yourself too much credit. He was young. That's all you need to be to get your hopes dashed. Be young. And everybody starts out young, so everybody's gonna get their hopes dashed. And besides, I don't think you really dash his hopes, because if you dash someone's hopes, well, that's kind of a nice way of letting them down, because it hurts. But it's quick. If you would have said no, that would have been dashing his hopes. But you didn't say no. You said nothing. You just didn't answer at all. And that is killing the hope, the long, slow, painful, because it's still there. Just hanging on, and it never really goes away. That is like giving somebody a little less air to breathe every day till they die.
Yeah. Okay. Well, thank you.
For what?
Oh.
I don't know.
Goodbye, Hope.
Goodbye. I'm so sorry to bother you. It's just I was all alone out there in the world with no place in it, and I realized when... Wait. You called me Hope. How did you know my name? Danny?
Hello, Hope.
Danny, I didn't even recognize. recognize you.
I know.
You're so...
I know.
Small.
I must not hope that I'll do a number on you.
Danny, I'm so sorry I never realized.
Shh, because you know something? You're early.
What?
You're early. You said be back with an answer to my question before the sun came up. And see some crow? The sun's not even close to being up yet. I only went down a few hours ago. Look how early you are. So a taxi all the way from Bangor?
Yep.
To tell me...
Honey? Dan? Hun, who's there?
Just somebody that needs directions.
It's awful late for directions.
Yeah, Susan, listen, I'll be right up.
Okay. What?
I hope you find it, Hope. Your place in this room. Bye.
Goodbye, Danny. Yes.
Beans and Prinks at the swimming pool club?
Yeah.
20 miles back, a couple of beers at the Moose and Patty?
Awesome.
And boy, you flew on your sled, man.
It's a Polaris, man.
I know, and you whooped my butt.
That's what you get for riding Art's cat. You get your butt whooped. And I whooped it.
I know.
Whooped your butt.
I know.
Whooped it.
I know.
Whooped your butt, Arctic cat, man.
I know. I'm not saying you didn't.
You're not beating the Snowmobile Association's Snowmobiler of the Year, you know?
I know.
That was fun.
This is... well, we've been together now.
Together?
Well...
together? What are you talking about?
Well,
together?
We've been friends for quite a few years
now. Are you
now,
getting all girl on me?
Shh. And here.
What are you doing here, bud?
Open.
Together, I don't know about this.
Just to open it. Do you mean, what is it? Can't you see what it is?
It's a picture.
Yeah.
A painting.
Yeah.
Where'd you get this? It looks homemade.
What do you mean it looks homemade?
It looks like somebody really painted it.
Well, somebody really did paint it.
Did you paint this?
Yeah.
For me?
Yeah.
Oh. Why?
Well,
I mean, thank you.
There you go. That's
what
I'm gonna say.
Thanks.
There you go.
Yeah.
You're welcome.
So, Dave, I didn't know you painted.
Yeah, this is.
Oh.
I'm taking adult at art. And nights. Merle Hansel and Rep, the high school's teaching it. And this is my version of one of those stare until you see the thing things. Ever seen one of these? Some of the old parents did it with dots. They called it something. But I did it with a bunch of little blocks of colors, see? And if you just look at the little blocks of colors, it's just colors. But if you take a step back and take a look at the whole thing, it's a picture of something.
Picture of what?
I'm not going to tell you. You have to figure it
out. Oh, come on, Dave.
No, it can take a little time. It can be a little frustrating.
Well, why would you give me something that's going to
frustrate you? No, I just mean you gotta not try to look for anything. That's what will frustrate you. You just gotta kinda look at it. This doesn't know what you're looking at.
What are you talking about?
You gotta trick it. Trick it. Trick it. Trick it. Gotta not let it know, and hopefully you'll eventually see what it is. There you go. There you go.
This is stupid. I don't see anything.
No, you're doing good.
Dave!
All right, then do this. Do what you normally do around the house and check out real casual like. And
I usually have a bud and talk to you on the phone.
Well, where's the kitchen outside? Get your bud and talk to me.
No!
What?
I'm all out of bud. Only got natty light.
All right, I'll get your natty light and
talk
to me.
We gotta trick this thing, right?
Hey,
tricking it.
How many years are you? I come out here every Friday night. I ain't never been inside your house for beers. It's unnatural. It's unnatural,
brother.
So let's go inside and get a couple of beers.
Hey, Dave! Quit running your sock. I gotta look at this thing.
You're doing it wrong.
Shh.
You gotta trick it.
Hey. Okay. I got some.
Yeah.
Roadkill.
What?
Roadkill. Dead raccoon in the middle of the road.
What? No, it's not a dead raccoon.
Okay. Deer. Dead bloody deer in the middle of the road.
Wrong. No, it's not a dead bloody deer in the middle of the road.
Okay. Moose. Dead bloody moose in the middle of the road.
No, it's not a dead bloody moose in the middle of the road. That's
well,
not even close to what it is. That's not something I want to paint.
Come on. He's a crow.
You don't know what it is?
No.
Can I give you a hint?
Yeah. What are you doing? What was that? Why did you do that?
Because I was giving you a hint.
Well, don't ever do that again. Ever. And get out of here.
Jeez and bro. Hey, Rhonda.
What?
You really are what they say.
What? What do they say?
That you're all hung up there.
Well, who says?
Everybody.
Everybody who?
Everybody, Rhonda. It's what people in town say.
When?
When they're talking. They say that you're a little hung up there, so I gotta be a little persistent there, they say. And they were right.
Well, who says?
Suzette.
Suzette?
Yeah, and Dan.
Suzette and Dan Harding say that I'm a little hung up there, and that you've gotta be a little persistent there. Well, who else?
Marcy.
Marcy?
Yeah, and Phil. And
Marcy and
Lyndall
Phil?
And Gail and Dina
Gail?
And Shelly and Marvel and Eric and Jimmy and Sabrina and East.
East?
Yeah, that's just to name a few.
Well, why would they? I love those guys. I'm good to those guys. That's talking about me and that's mean.
No, Rhonda. I don't think they'd be mean. I think they said that about you to me to kind of warn me what you're just getting myself into with you. Because they like you. And me. Us. They're rooting for us, Rhonda.
Who's rooting for us?
Everybody, East and Gail and Lyndall and Shelly and Dina.
Well, they never told me they were rooting for us.
Well, that's because you're a little hung up there. I'm sorry if I made you mad. I don't know what I did wrong. I mean, I just gave you a kiss. How about you give me one back? That's the polite thing to do, you know? Get a kiss, give a kiss, very clear. Just give me a kiss, Rhonda.
I don't know how.
What do you mean?
I've never done it before. I don't know how.
You never kiss?
I won arm wrestling at every winter carnival from 5th grade on. I work in plywood at Bushy's Lumber Mill. That's not exactly what most men want.
Well, now, where do you get that?
From everybody.
Well, then, Rhonda, you got it wrong.
because I know a lot of guys that take good long looks at you. Holy cow, so you never have?
No.
Well, gosh, I think that's kind of. How about you do me a favor? Give me a kiss. I won't make fun of you or nothing bad like that. I promise.
No. We gotta do this. It's apples, cherries, a big open face strawberry rhubarb pot. Oh, Dave! I see it. It's nice. You're really good at this.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And you're really good at this.
I thought it'd be hard, and it's not at all. And I feel like I want to do it for a really long time, but I also want to do something else next, but I don't know what that is.
I do. Well, yeah, how about we go inside? I'll show you what comes next.
Well, how long is that gonna take?
It could take all night. Maybe longer.
Well, wait a second. We're working tomorrow. First shift.
Says who?
You mean we're calling in? We're calling Shelly, because you and I are not working first shift or any shift tomorrow. You get yourself in here, Mr. Arts Catman. Dave!